Life too short, gotta chase this dream, baby. La 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 la.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy 71J, and you already know what's going on. We back with another lit video, you feel me? In today's video, we finna be going over how I make my thumbnails, man. How exactly do I go through the whole process, you feel me? Here's a couple examples of the thumbnails I made so far. Right here, you know what I'm saying? Right here, and then one last one right here. So as y'all can see, my work is pretty good, if I do say so myself, you know what I'm saying? It's pretty good for YouTube thumbnails, and it's quick, it's easy, it's on the phone, it's mobile, it's nothing too crazy. You don't have to go through Photoshop and spend 10-15 minutes doing it. Yeah, we finna just be going over this whole video and going over the process of how I get them done, so that when you making your YouTube videos, you don't gotta worry about, dang, how do I make my thumbnails, you feel me? I'm finna give y'all the whole game right now, so y'all stay tuned. So the two, maybe three apps you're gonna need for the most part is Superimpose X right here. Gotta have Superimpose X, man. This is the main one. This is the editing app, you feel me? This is what you're gonna use to edit your thumbnail on. You also gonna need Fonto. Fonto is the app I use for text. I don't put text on all my thumbnails, but for the most part, I use Fonto, you know what I'm saying? Because they got more fonts on there that let you edit the fonts a little bit better. So I use that. And then the last app I use is Pixart. Pixart, the third app. My home screen a little everywhere. Don't worry about it, man. I just be having apps here and there, downloading them, deleting them, and all that. But yeah, let's go ahead and get into this, man. I don't want to take too much of y'all time, and I don't know how much storage I got on my phone, and I don't want to run out of storage on this video. But yeah, okay, cool. So as y'all can see, I got a history full of just thumbnails I've made over time and stuff like that. But we finna start a whole new one, and all you gotta do is hit this blue plus sign. So let me find an album. All right, so right here I got an album full of just different things I be using here and there, like a little pack, I guess I'd say. But different things I use to add on my thumbnails. If I want to add on something else, I'll probably just look it up, like a PNG version or whatever it is, and then like digital text box. All you gotta do is just go to digital text bubble. I hit that, hit the first link, make a pixel speech bubble. Click that, and then you can type in whatever you want to do. Let's say, hey, you know what I'm saying? You can move which way you want the spike to be going towards. However you want to do it, you hit create, and there it go, it pop up for you. Then you hit download. I download it, hit the little link in the bottom left. If I'm moving too fast for y'all, just go back and rewind it. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I'm trying to hurry this up so I don't run out of storage on my phone. But yeah, hit that little blue arrow in the bottom. Then I hit downloads right here. And then I click on what I just downloaded. Click on it. And then it brings you to this link. And now from here, you just save. Hit the little bottom left. And you save the image. All right, so boom. Now that's in there. Going back to Superimpose X, I'm going to use this picture I just took randomly. You feel me? Just a random picture I took. My first step is going over to the dimensions. So YouTube dimensions for the thumbnails is 16:9. Click on that, and I can crop it, size it however I want it. I want to get all my hair in there. I can see my full hand, so I'm gonna just use this. Boom. So now you got your first image, right? Your first layer. I like to duplicate it like at least 2 or 3 times, just because I might need it again. So all you gotta do to duplicate. Why is that hard to say? All you gotta do to duplicate is click on it one time, the layer right here. Right here. Click on it, and then you hit duplicate. Duplicate. Now you got two of them. If you want to do 3 of them, you can do 3, you can do 4. There used to be a limit on how many layers you can have overall in your project. I don't know if there still is, but I normally get to like 8 and be smooth. You don't really need too much more than that, I don't think, but you know, just in case. But yeah, so that's the first thing you do, is duplicate it or triple it or however many times you're gonna need it. And then I also like to add another layer of just one color. Preferably white, just so I can have, you know what I'm saying, just a white background for when I start to crop. So let me go back real quick just so I can show y'all exactly what I did. I hit the blue arrow right here, hit the blue arrow, then I hit photos. photos is going, like adding is going to add in whatever else you want to add to the project. Hit photos to add in more photos, so you can add in whatever other pictures or whatever other things you need to add, screenshots, whatever it is. But right now we're going to add a new color. So I go down there to colors, go back to 16x9 because those are the dimensions. And then I can change the color at the bottom. You see this little black circle? You can hit that and change the color to whatever color you want it to be. So I'm going to choose white for this one right here. And then yeah, we're going to fix it. It automatically fixes it. And so now you see it's kind of like small in the middle. You can use this same layer. Since I'm on the white paper layer, I can hit move to move it however I want it to do. Make it a little bit bigger or whatever. If I want to rotate it, I can do that by hitting the rotate thing, but it ain't working right now for some reason. Oh, there you go, right there. Hit the little top left. But anyways, we finna just fit to base at the bottom right. Hit fit to base and it's already like, you know, symmetrical or whatever. And then now I'm gonna move it into the middle in between the two layers I already had, right? So boom, back on the first layer. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna crop out my body and my head and my face and everything, so y'all can get like a full outline. I can blur the background and I can start working on the project some more. So first things first, hit that erase. Hit the mask tool so you can decide whatever brush you want to use. If you want to do just the magic wand, this kind of gives more like a broader, you know what I'm saying, just to kind of grab a whole lot at one time, but I don't like to use it. You also got the lasso tool. You got other brushes, but I use the brush, the regular brush, most of the time, just because it gives more detail. After that, all you do is just erase everything that you don't want on the first layer. And I like to zoom in kind of close so I can get like real detail with it and get kind of close to the body. And then yeah, you just kind of go along real slow along the outlines or whatever it is you edging. So I ain't gonna take y'all through this whole process because like I said, I ain't trying to use up all my storage, man. I want to make sure I can get the whole video out. But I'm gonna let y'all know when I'm done with this. All right, so as y'all can see, I'm done trimming it up, cropping it out. And now that I'm done with this white layer, I don't need it no more. I can go ahead and delete it. All the white layer was for was just so that I could crop out the background and have something to, like, you know, use as a background layer, so I can see where exactly I'm cutting out. Now that's out the way, I like to go ahead and go to the bottom layer, the layer before, because as y'all can see, y'all can't see on the picture, but using two different layers, if I was to move the top layer, you know what I'm saying, I can move it around wherever I wanted to go with it. And then you can also hit the back arrow right here, the back left, and it'll turn, you know, redo or undo whatever you just did. Now I want to take the bottom layer and I can do whatever I want to with it, right? So what I'm about to do right now, straight up, the first thing is just to blur it out. So I hit the filter right there at the bottom, hit blur, and then you can blur it out to whatever level you want to blur it. I like to go like a light blur, you know what I'm saying, just to kind of enhance the overall picture. And so I'll hit about 15, cool, around 15, anywhere between 15, it's cool. But yeah, so we did that. And now if I want to add a color, I can also add a color just to spice it up a little bit. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit that arrow again, add colors, and I can add whatever color I want to. Right here, I might wanna go gradient. I'm gonna go gradient, yeah. So you can switch it up however you want it to look. Change the color by going, let me see, let's go blue. Let's go blue. All right, so boom, blue, and then from the blue, I want to fade into more of a black. Matter of fact, let's flip this. I want to do blue at the top, then black at the bottom. More so like that. Yeah, that's cool. So 16, again, hit that arrow, and now you got the gradient. So now I can move it again to resize it and make sure it fits the whole thing, and now I just bring that down over the bottom layer. So now, as y'all can see, it's covering up the bottom layer, you can't see nothing. But all you gotta do now is hit the blend at the bottom right, and then you can change how you want to blend it. So I like to use screen because it gives it like it still shows the background the most, and you can change the opacity to see how exactly, you feel me, you want it to show up and how dark you want it to be or whatever the case is. So I'm gonna do around like 25 just to give it a little bit more color, you feel me? A little bit more color. Let's change it a little bit more. Add a little bit more, probably like 50. About 50. Yeah, that's cool. Alright, so we really just enhancing it right now. I just wanted to make this pop, you feel me? Now our next step is to get an outline of my body and my head and everything. So I'm gonna hit tools, scroll down the tools, and I'm gonna hit mask outline. So y'all see they got a big fat line. You can go as fat or skinny as you want to, but I'm gonna go around about right here. You feel me? And so now I got pretty much the basics of it down. You feel me? As y'all can tell, this is what most thumbnails, a lot of thumbnails be looking like. So now you can just add other different things here and there just to sauce it up some more. So this is how I'm gonna do it, right? So add layer. The next layer I'm about to add is going to be these blue spiral, like these, this wheel. Add that, move it, fit to base, put it behind my body, and then as y'all can see, it's covering up everything, but y'all know how to get that out of the way. You hit blend, hit screen, and now, you know what I'm saying? You feel me? Do it how you want to do it. So I'm gonna put it around about right here, and then I want it to look a little bit more behind me, so I'm gonna change it up a little bit. I'm gonna move it a little bit. There you go. Boom. All right, so that's done. Now I can add another layer. Why is a car insurance thing texting me? Add another layer, photos. What else I wanna add? Now add the bars on the outside. Same thing, move it to base. And for this one, this is black, so you get the same thing. Boom, you feel me? And now you got the bars on the outside. I like to put my body or like the most poppy thing on top of that still. But that's that. And then after that, I can still add little, you know, like the little digital camera squares or whatever. So I added that, move that how I want it to be. You feel me? Fit right there in the corners. And there you go. Boom. If you ever want to get real detailed with it, you can just hold the layer and it'll bring up these little arrows right here. And now you can tap the arrows wherever you want them to go to get real detailed, more, you know what I'm saying, precise with it. But I normally get it pretty good the first time. So yeah, that's that. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add on another arrow pointing at me just to make it look a little bit more emphasized on me. I'm going to flip this. I'm going to have this coming in from somewhere on the side. Boom, you feel me? And I'm doing this because I'm gonna have text in the next step. And now I'm pretty much done with the basics of it. This looks like a good thumbnail to me. You know what I'm saying? A cool little thumbnail, some simple stuff, you feel me? You feel me? All right, cool. So what we gonna do is we gonna save it, hit the top right, little square at the top right, and hit photos, and save to your photos. So boom, now it's in my gallery. Now what we gonna do is we gonna go to Fonto. Fonto pretty much, like I said, adds all the text, all the different types of text and whatnot. So, boom, go to Fonto, go to our gallery, pick the last picture we just edited and saved, and now it's right here on our Fonto project or whatever, new project. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna tap. It's gonna wherever you tap it, it doesn't matter. It's gonna pull up add text, and now you can say whatever you want to say. So I'm gonna put thumbnail. Oh, I forgot to do something. I told y'all I wanted to add a digital text box, so I'm gonna go to digital text box, change this to what I want it to be, and I want this one to say yo. So now I'm gonna create that, and there it goes. Download it, save it. Maybe I'm moving kind of fast because I do this often, but now it's in my gallery, and I'm about to go back to Superimpose X, add that real quick. Boom, boom, boom. And all right, so cool. So as y'all can see, I don't want to crop this one out because this is like, it's too much to really go straight lines and stuff like that. I don't really feel like cropping this out. So this is actually where I would go and hit the eraser tool and change the mask tool to the magic wand because it gets out like the bulk of one color. So I hit the white, move on it, and now it took out all the white that was in the background. You can do it a little bit more, it's gonna take out the next second like closest color, so that took out the gray. That's pretty much all I wanted to take out. So now that I got that in there, I can hit move again, put it in the corner by my face where I want it to be at, and boom. And also I forgot to do a couple more things too. I'm glad I went back to do this. I can cast shadow and give it like some background, you know what I'm saying? Like some shadow, you feel me? Some shadow in the background. And I'm actually gonna move this a little bit more to the left. So yeah. And then I also like to give like a little trim sometimes, a little white trim, just to make it pop a little bit more. For my Aero 2. Alright, boom. So I got those. Add the shadow to my Aero. You can change it however you want to look. You can change the color too. Make it white, make it more pop more. You can make it red. Let's do red this time. As a matter of fact, let's change this shadow to white. You feel me? And then I'm gonna put it behind my head so that my head pops out more. And now we finna work on the head, add a shadow to that. You feel me? And we just tweaking it, you know what I'm saying? There's not much to it. There's not a whole lot that you gotta worry about. You know what I'm saying? It's really down. I got it down to a science now, but it's kind of simple, man. Once you start doing it a couple times, you'll get good with it. Ain't nothing crazy. But yeah, that's pretty much it so far. So boom, this is what I want to say. This looks a little bit better, a little bit more energized. And if you want to add one more thing, let's go ahead and do that too. I'm about to add an emoji. So to add an emoji, what you do is you hit the layer again. You add empty layer this time because you need to have just a blank space and nothing with it but the emoji. So now you got empty layer. You're gonna move it to fit the base. And then now you're gonna hit tools and you're gonna hit text. So I double tap the text and I wanna add the shocked emoji. That's a common emoji. Add the shocked one. Hit and confirm it, and now I can move that wherever I want it to. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna put it right here. Put it right there. Again, I wanna put it behind my face and my body because I want my body to pop out. Well, actually, nah. I'm gonna put it on top of my body this time. And now same thing, give it a little outline. You feel me? And then I'm gonna give it a little shadow too. This time I'm probably gonna use black just because it's in front of my hand. White look good. Yeah, we're gonna do black. Alright, boom. So that's pretty much what we got so far. And now I'm about to save this and go back to Fonto. So as y'all can see, this is another thing, like a little quick tip for Fonto. If you ever start on one picture and want to change to another picture, because I do it all the time, say I was to go ahead and type something in and just put it right there and then it's there. You feel me? And I already been working on it and I'm mad, like, dang, I want to use a different picture. I can always just hit the camera at the bottom and you got options now. So I can add another photo, I can do whatever, replace it, and I want to replace only the image. So I'll hit that. And then, you know what I'm saying, go back to my photos and choose the picture I just saved. And now replace everything but the text, right? So now I got a whole new picture in there with the same text. So for the fonts for the text, man, you have different ways you can add different fonts to your Fonto. Fonto normally comes with regular ones, like all of these. And these are all cool too. You got some simple ones in there. You got some cool like animated ones. You feel me? You got some good ones in here too. But if you want to use like the more YouTube recognizable, the Burbank Big Condensed, then you gotta go to, it's called DaFont. So DaFont. You go on DaFont, you gonna see like a whole bunch of different fonts. Let me show y'all. And now on here you got thousands or hundreds of thousands, tens of thousands of different fonts on here. So I'll just go straight to Burbank Big Condensed so I can show y'all. Go to the search real quick. Big Condensed. Where's that? Dang. Well, let's try something else then, because I don't want to leave y'all hanging. I told y'all I can go there. So let's see. Search the whole thing on Google. Let's try Fonts Market. All right, so yeah, there it is right there. So you'll just download it from whatever site you use on Google. I use that font to download it, but I guess they took it off of there. And you'll just download it from here. And I'm not gonna download it again because I already have it, but you download it from Google and it'll be in your files. And when you go to Fonto, you go to My Fonts, you can go to, you know what I'm saying, it'll teach you exactly how you can go and download whatever font it is. So I don't know why it wasn't on that font no more, because as y'all can see, it was on here too. Like, this is what they recommended. But yeah, anyways, back to Fonto. I'm using Burbank Big Condensed, and I'm gonna say fire. I'm gonna just do fire first, right? So fire, because I'm gonna do two words. So now I got the word fire up. I can move it wherever I want to. I can hit size to make it bigger. So I'm gonna do that, make it a little bit bigger, put it right here in front of my head. And then I'm gonna style it. So style is how you change the color and the look of it, right? So what I always do first, I go straight to style, and I hit the alpha and bring it all the way up, which basically just brings a background to it, gives it like a little bit more depth. make it pop a little bit more. And then I hit style again, go to stroke. You could change, you know what I'm saying? You can give it an outline if you want to, whatever it is. I do red for today, you feel me? And then you can also hit text and hit color pattern at the bottom, and it'll give you like a color pattern to use. I like to do the gradient because it gives it more of like a faded look. And here you can go to anywhere. You can go yellow to red, or you can add in more colors and add in let's make it look kind of cool. Yellow, add in some orange at the bottom, and then maybe some red at the very bottom. You feel me? Make it look hot. You feel me? It's fire. Maybe change the top one to white. There you go. You can tweak it how you want to, but we finna leave it right here just for now. That look like fire to me. Click on it again. Now I go over to this little square with another square on top of it, and that duplicates it. So now I got two of them, right? So boom. Now I got two different ones, and it just basically copied it, and I can change the text again, but it kept all the same settings from the first time I did it. So now that way I can keep the same thing. I have to remember everything I just did. But now I just changed the text. So thumbnail, I want this title to be fire thumbnails. All right, so we're gonna put it right here. I'm gonna make this a little bit smaller because I don't want to take up too much space, and that's about good right there. You feel me? So boom, and that's pretty much, that's it right there. Now if you want to get a little bit more detail, what you can do is you can save this. You feel me? Hit the save at the bottom. Save image. This is pretty much, this could be done right here. This could be the end of it. You feel me? This is all you really need to be done with the thumbnail. I could drop this right now, and it looks pretty good. It'll catch attention. Got some popping colors and whatnot, and it's cool. But also, to make it just a little bit better, I like to go to PixArt. And PixArt, this is what I'm about to do next. Gonna give it like a little bit more oomph to it. That's the best way I can say it. Like a little bit more. You know what I'm saying? Make it a little bit more catchy. So hit the plus at the bottom, go to photos, and you will see the last photo you just saved. Click on that, and now you're working on this one again from this app. So what I want to do is I'm gonna just hit FX at the bottom, hit HDR, and this gives it like that high contrast popping out like OD detail look. Now you could turn it down a little bit and tweak it to make it look a little bit better. I always go phase zero, blur around like 10, and then I'll unsharp it wherever I want it to be. So for this one, I'll put it around 50. I'll put it at 50 just so it pop a little bit, but it's not too detailed. You feel me? This look a little too detailed to me, a little hard to read the letters and stuff like that, but I'll put it at 50 just so it's smooth right there. And I'm gonna save this, and I'm done. And now there's one more step. You feel me? Y'all gotta like this video right now, bro. Y'all have to like this video, cause this last step I'm about to give y'all, it makes it so much better, bro. Y'all gonna see from the beginning to the end just how much, like, the steps it takes. Man, I'm giving y'all gems right now, bro. I'm telling y'all, I'm giving y'all gems. Y'all like this video, man. Like the video right now. Go ahead, bro. Y'all be thinking I'm gonna just wait on, like, I ain't gonna just wait on y'all. Like, come on, bro, like the video. Tripping, bro. Alright, bet, appreciate it. Damn, y'all tripping. Alright, so now what we finna do is, for the last step, just for the icing on the top to make the thumbnail pop OD, we finna hit photos. You feel me? And now we got the photo that we just worked on. And here it go, man. That's the photo right there. Compared to what it was, you feel me? It just look a little bit more detailed, a little bit more standing out, you feel me? It just look a little bit better. And so now what we finna do is, we finna edit this a little bit just to edit the colors. So you could hit auto, and auto make it look a little, but nah, I don't like how auto look. I like to do it myself. So we're gonna go over to its brilliance. Now brilliance, I like to throw this all the way to the top sometimes, cause brilliance just make it from wherever it's set automatically just to brilliant. You feel me? Just magnificent. Mwah. You feel me? But we ain't gonna go all the way to the top cause it's a little bit too bright. I'm gonna put it around 50. Boom, now we go to highlights. We can change the highlights however you want to do it. I looked a little light skin, a little bit too light skin anymore, you feel me? So we're gonna drop the highlights just down a little bit to about 30. You feel me? We're finna turn the contrast. I'm really good with the contrast. The PixArt really did that for the most for us. Change the brightness and turn that down a little bit. 15. And now it looks a little bit better. Now I like to make the colors pop too. and so I can turn the saturation up a little bit. Now, you don't always have to do this, because a lot of times when you're using popping colors already, and you just like, it automatically does it through the apps. But to change the saturation if you want to, you can. Actually, I ain't even gonna do it for this one. Vibrant, same thing. You know, you can do it a little bit if you want to, just to make it look a little bit more standout-ish. So we're gonna turn it up to 25. Just so the background can pop a little bit more. And now, yeah, man, pretty much done, bro. It's pretty much a done thumbnail, you feel me? Now I can look at it from what it used to be. And that was the original before I started working on it. You feel me? And it's cool. It's still straight. But it just look a little bit more in your face. You feel me? Look a little bit more detailed, touched up a little bit. You feel me? And that's what I like. I like this shit to be looking good. You feel me? So that's what we're going to go with. And that's what's going to be the thumbnail for this video. Y'all see it. Y'all know what it is. You know what I'm saying? Boom. Your boy just blessed, man. Your boy just blessed for the video. Y'all make sure y'all go down to the comment section right now and drop what y'all want to make a thumbnail on. Y'all next video y'all gonna drop a thumbnail for. You feel me? Let me know if y'all want to see this. If y'all want to pack for everything I just added for my thumbnails, I'll DM them to you. You know what I'm saying? I'm real like that. I'll do it for you. You feel me? And yeah, man, that's pretty much all it is to it. Ain't nothing crazy. Y'all make sure y'all stop procrastinating. Y'all go drop a video today. Matter of fact, film two of them and do two thumbnails and then drop one of them day after day. You feel what I'm saying? Get on your grind. If you want to do YouTube for real, just go ahead and do it, man. I'm doing it with y'all. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can go on the journey with me. If y'all watching me, y'all just want to watch this for entertainment, y'all make sure y'all hit that bell icon so y'all can say tune in for every time I drop a video. And you tune in and you link up with the gang. You know what I'm saying? With all that being said, man, I appreciate y'all for watching this video from the start to the end. You feel me? It's your boy 71J. It's good vibes only. You know what I'm saying? And we gone.
Life too short, gotta chase this dream, baby. La 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 la.